Hey Star Wars fans, another FLYGUY.net review. This time it's Plo Koon Winter Gear, or Snowplo, as I like to call him. This has to be the silliest facial mask I've ever seen. Maybe there's weirder figures out there, but this just is a silly looking mask on this guy, in my opinion. It doesn't quite work for me, however, it certainly wasn't looking quite as bad as that when this appeared in a Clone Wars comic book. We got to see this and Kit Fisto in this kind of winter gear that they have. But let me go through the figure in a little bit more and we'll show you underneath the mask and all the other bits and details that come with Snowplo. So lightsaber first of all, let's have a look at that. Apparently this is the right lightsaber that he's got. I'm not a huge knowledgeable person on if it's the right lightsaber or not. I think it is. You can see a slight nodule there. You'd think that would clip onto a belt, but it's not big enough. It's all as usual, one piece and painted. Oops, there we go, focus. So one lightsaber, pretty standard. Let's get this mask off. The mask itself, you'll see, clips onto the facial sculpt, but take it off and you've got regular Plo underneath, which is pretty detailed, and we'll come back and show you in a minute. The mask itself, you'll see, is molded to fit. You can just, if you're zooming in mega high def, which again, just change your controls on YouTube, you can watch it. You'll see just about there, there's even small plastic elements so it clips into his eyes. So very much a really hugging kind of mask. It fits right on a Plo's face, all over his kind of breathing apparatus that he has, and even down to the little dots in his eyes. So there we go, all the grooves. And again, it's just the front part of it there. This very sad clown-like looking face. Very bizarre. Anyway, so on with the rest of the figure. One thing that is notable is you can remove this hood that he has here. So removing the head, hopefully this will come off easy, there we go. You get this kind of parka hood, which you can take off. Doesn't quite work without it. You'll see if we put the head back on. It's not too bad, but in fact, it's not so bad actually. It's not so bad. When you take it off, the head is the paintwork underneath wasn't that great. It's a little spilled over, I thought, in some places, just down at the top. But actually, not a bad aspect at all. So there you go. Plo without his parka, or with. But I'll put this back on just for this review here. So. Let me put that back on. There we go. The other feature that he's got on him is Snowplo kind of crampons. We discussed this at length in the podcast. Episode 15, which will be out literally a day after this video, so have a check out for that when Sith Lord 229, Rasputin 37 and myself go over Snowplo and Savage Opress that we just reviewed as well. So there's his little crampon boots for Snow Adventures. Nice aspect there. It's got the hole in the bottom of the crampon for his element on his foot to plug in, and it's a really snug fit. So he puts on his almost slipper-like things, and it plugs into the bottom, and they really stay on very tightly. So these are his little shoes. Rest of the figure, in terms of articulation on Plo, you get limited movement on a ball-jointed head there because of the parka piece, and apart from that, you could take that obviously off and you'd get full rotation. So a ball-jointed head, ball-jointed shoulders, ball-jointed shoulders, ball-jointed elbows, and swivel wrists, swivel waist. And a plastic, very soft, good skirt, very like the Savage Press we just reviewed again. You'll see very flexible swivel hips, ball jointed knees, and no articulation in the ankles. I'll just show you that, there's nothing there at all, just to be sure. So not too bad. The one I've got, this figure when it arrived with me, I bought this off eBay, although I've got some orders come along to make up some other missing items from BigBadToyStore.com, some carded versions of this, but this version that came here had very sticky knees, and the figure didn't bend very well. So if you're buying this online, before you take the figure and you just decide to bend the knee, watch that underneath at the back there, you can just see some white plastic. Mine was a little stressed in terms of the plastic, so it was just glued a little bit still, straight at the factory, wherever it was. Maybe this one just was out of the quality control, it didn't make it because of that, but that's certainly something to watch. Don't just bend it too quickly. Best thing to do is maybe take a small cutting knife or a Stanley knife, just tiny put it in there, or a craft knife kind of thing, and ease up the plastic and the glue from between the knees and the joint, so that allows that to bend, because you could easily snap that knee. It's quite fragile in some ways. So there we go, let me give you a better close up and look at Adam, and again, whack this up to HD if you want to really see some of the detail there. So facial sculpt again, really nice touch. Because of the facial mask with those small dots, what that's allowed for, let me see if I can give you a real close up here as I poke this through your computer monitor. You can just see the eyes there with those small holes. That adds a real piece of realism that we've never really seen before. That's a detailed aspect there. The eyes look really like Plo does in the show. Those kind of small inlets. So that's a nice touch by Hasbro on that design aspect. Emblem on his chest. Mine's is a slightly off to an angle there. And I believe a few others, because we've got several others for some friends, had the same slightly off to the left emblem. Other than that, no other real details other than the emblems on the arm. That's on the other arm too. Oops. And that's pretty much it in terms of the other kind of interesting features, I think, of paintwork. He's got these kind of wraps on his feet and nothing else really on the back other than his very well painted head. They've done some nice, you wouldn't call it weathering, but they've certainly put the grooves, filled them with paint. Let me just, I'm sorry folks, shaking all over here, too much caffeine. You can just see the grooves there where they put some of the paint in, and it gives that real flesh brown kind of, well, it just makes Plo look like Plo. And lots of kind of detail. The plastic's very detailed as well. It's kind of given a slightly mottled or kind of orange peel-like effect to give Plo this kind of skin-like appearance on his head. So very detailed, it's really nice, even down to the breathing mask, this kind of the ornate kind of way that his mask is, I guess, molded or put together has been done here pretty well. So the mask doesn't come off all one piece. That's pretty much it. That's Snow Plo for you. Again, bought this online, got some more coming from BigBadToyStore.com, some carded ones, some other very cool figures in this wave, and you can check out some high-res photographs for this guy and all the others in our Facebook image gallery, which you can find at facebook.com/flyguy.net. And join us there and let us know what you think. You getting these figures? Thank you to everyone who's been sharing some of their finds and hauls on the Facebook page as well. It's good to see what you guys are getting, and again, some of the prices and things that you're picking up. Some great conversations as well. So, join us there or leave a comment below, and we've got some more reviews coming up kind of soon. Cheers.